Which of the following, if true, could have prevented the Iranian revolution from being regarded as a revolution? So the passage, when it talks about the similarities, mentions that there are certain parameters that made the Iranian revolution look like a revolution. Right. So what are those parameters? Those parameters are all mentioned here. So let's see. If the mosque had not played a critical role in it. In fact, if the mosque had not played a critical role, it would have become more like the other revolutions. So this is not the correct answer choice. If it had demanded fundamental economic and social changes. So this is anyway a point of similarity, political freedom, etc., etc. So these demands are not going to prevent it from being called as a revolution. We are interested in preventing it from being called as a revolution. So this is not correct. So it has to basically step away from the characteristics of a general revolution. If it had not voiced the concerns of social classes excluded from the power structure. Yes. Now the first similarity is the collective actions were initiated by social causes and groups that had been excluded from the power structure. So this is the main point that characterizes it as a revolution. So if it had not voiced it, if it did not have this point, then it would have been more difficult to call it a revolution. So this is a very good answer choice because this will prevent it from being called as a revolution. If Khomeini had not emphasized on an egalitarian society, so Khomeini did emphasize on an egalitarian society, but he did so after the revolution. So what happened after the revolution would not connect to whether the revolution would be called as a revolution or not. So this is not a correct answer choice. If it had lacked peasant participation, in fact it did lack peasant participation, but still it's a revolution. So this is not correct. So the correct answer here would be C.